step worse than fate. And so, the boom of horror was unmasked at last, and laid to rest by the side of his hideous clockwork dog, Toto.
Very good, isn't it?
Our labors now completed, the great defective Hemlock Stones and I, his patient doctor and biographer, returned directly to our dodgings at 99 Bakersfield Street. Thankful that for tonight at least, Londoners might sleep forever under a comforting blanket of thick English industrial fog.
Splendid.
That's it, Stones.
Splendid.
The adventure of the swollen sock.
It's quite commercial. They'll eat it up, old bean.
Yes, it takes care of last month's rent, too, you see.
By the by, have we eaten up all those old beans, Flotsam? I'm famished. Go rat about in the cupboard and see, old man.
I'll give it the old army try. We've been gone, you know. Probably spoiled.
Hello, what's this? This solution's turning blue. Not quite the solution I expected. That means the rat should have lived and the captain should have died, of course. Let's see. Norveticus ratus, Norveticus asses, mammalia, rodentia meridae. Here we are. That's black and brown. Eats electricity.
The rats have gotten to everything but this half tin of Uncle Sigmund's Peruvian cocoa powder.
That'll be all right. Did you know, Flotsam, that if rats were the size of English children, they could wipe us out in a week?
Shocking. I don't want to hear about it. Here's your cocoa.
Thank you,
milk, sugar?
No, I'll take it straight.
We'll just have some tea if you don't mind.
They're the most advanced animal weapon of destruction yet created.
Hey, we can pay this month's rent, you know, and have a little left over for food if you'll just tell me a second story.
What am I, a second story man? If it's adventures you want, make them up yourself. Look, here, in the London Exaggerator, it's full of them. Man coughs up towel in Brussels. Yankee pig nut swindle shocks Parliament. Sultan insulted in mele-mele. Giant green cheese stolen. Aha!
Oh, what's wrong, Stones?
I sat on my pipe, but no matter. For I perceive that hidden behind this seemingly unrelated sequence of events, there lurks a singular, sinister attitude of mind.
Whose?
Mine!
Oh!
No, Piltdown, old man. You might as well ask who's behind the giant rat of Sumatra.
Oh, very well, Stones. Who's behind is the giant rat of Sumatra.
Damn, you're fat, Swallow.
What?
Fast fats, no. But I shall never be tricked into telling a tale for which the world is not yet prepared.
Then we'd better be prepared for thin times, old scout. There's only a spoon of cocoa left in the can.
Yes, to live, a rat must chew.
So must we all. We eat or we die, eh?
I did not say eat. I said chew.
Gesundheit.
Gesundheit, of course. Gesundheit, Dankeschön, the chip's Prussian captain. Frigate!
Oh, really, Stones?
Frigate Matilda, plying her illicit trade in rubber goods and spiders up and down the Mokujava Strait from Singapore to Sinatra. Frankly, Flotsam, it's all beginning to make sense.
Let's turn sense to pounds, old man. Tell me the whole bizarre story.
Well, yes, I suppose I can tell you, but the public must never know.
I'll just write that down.
It was long before I met you, Doctor.
Oh, really?
Yes.
You went to the Met.
You were in Afghanistan.
I was wearing Stanley's Afghan.
I was playing the Outer Islands with a small theatrical company. We were holed up in a rat-infested pension in Goonrot.
Really? Oh, rat-infested tension in Goonrot.
You see, Claxon, if they don't chew, their teeth grow through their brains.
How very incisive.
It was a close and muggy day. There had been three muggings in the lobby since dawn. I wisely kept to my room, but there came a sudden beating at my door.
What? I'll get it.
No, it's part of the story. I rose unsteadily to my feet, took careful aim with my trembling Wembley, the door swung open...
Good morning, Mrs. Moriarty.
I fired point blank.
Mrs. Moriarty, my dear lady, let me help you.
Look at this great V in my chest.
Are you hurt?
Ah, faith and Gomorrah, doctor. By the blood of St. Mencius, I'm from Ireland, and as you used to ducking bullets, as you are to ducking billets.
Oh, well, yes.
And here's last month's.
We'll squeeze out your rent as soon as Fleet Street runs our latest penny dreadful through the press. Don't worry.
I never worry, Mr. Stones, especially when there's a high-heeled foreign lady and her heathen servant waiting for you on the footpad below.
A case at last.
We'll show her up.
I'd be glad to. Mr. Stones will see you now, you cheap whore.
She's been nipping at the rat cheese again.
I deduce that we're about to be entertained by an American ingenue from upstate New York.
How the deuce do you deduce that?
The taps on her shoes, footman. They resounded a frequency produced by a unique alloy of aluminium and magnesium manufactured in Chicago, but shuffled off to Buffalo.
Uncanny inspiration, Stones.
Yes, and here's the last inspiration from this can.
Mr. Hemlock Stones, I presume.
Oh, aren't you the presumptuous one?
Oh, am I?
Come in, but I would advise you to leave your man outside.
But without Monsieur Benway, I should be lost.
Il est necessary que je remain ici. Here.
Ah, Canadian.
Oh, Mr. Stones, I'm in a desperate fix. I need your help.
I'm in desperate need of a fix myself. I'll help you. Batman, take her purse.
Here, my dear.
Thank you, and my cloak, Doctor.
And her dress.
Thank you, and my knickers. Thank you.
And your muff.
Oh, that's my muff.
Soccer blue.
Why, without your clothes, you're naked, Miss Dudley. Miss Violet Dudley, isn't it?
How did you know my moniker?
From the rather provocative initials on your knickers. And this scandalous article in tomorrow's Times.
Oh, let me see that. Farmer takes sprouts and rust. Oh, no. Here it is. Senator Soubrette found naked in detective's flat. But I'm not flat. Look.
Oh, I'll just make a note of that.
Oh, make it a B note.
Make it a C note, miss, and we'll take the case.
But this is a case of the pox.
Not quite. Poxon, we're about to embark on the strange case of the missing...
Yes?
Plot.
Very funny.
What is this all about, my dear?
Well, I've forgotten.
Why, give him the no... Il est importante, give him the secret massage, mademoiselle.
Oh, would you like a massage, Mr. Scones?
No, yes. Note es correcto.
Oh, the note. Oh, well, Benway found this mysterious billet doux in my dress this morning, Mr. Stones. I showed it to our Daddy Dudley, like I do every night. And he said I should show it to you. What do you think?
This is a rebus written in a simple head code. Any English schoolboy could catch it.
Flotsam, yes. Pull down the simple English schoolboy's decoding manual.
Of course.
It's as clear as the nose on my face. Wait a minute. It's gone. Oh, no. No, here it is in my hand.
Now, look this up.
Yes.
Two dancing boys, a tower and a tiny tortoise, minus a tin toilet, plus two heels, an L, and an electric eel.
Here it is. Long-toothed man fears for brain, desires AC-DC connection.
There's our tune again.
Take tube, no professionals or phonies. Is necked correct height?
You use initials only.
Is necked correct height? Initials, Achtung!
Yes,
it's correct.
It's an official Mormon jigsaw. A German mix-up code.
Let me see that. It's in the back of the book here. Write this down.
Of course, I will.
See, a B is a G and a B and a P. Violent Grugley.
Oh, Violent Dudley!
Dudley, a D is a G and a P is a B. Pick up Basel tonight.
What?
Parcel tonight. Dogs, curs. Curse of India! Curse of India!
Filthy pirate.
Know me by my wanger. No, my wingnut. Know me by my tool.
Perhaps that's instrument. Know me by my instrument, yes.
Oh, but it does sound so dangerous, Mr. Stones. Could you go for me?
If you put on a little weight.
Oh, I'll wait forever.
Wait here.
Wait, huh?
Oui, monsieur.
Flotsam, you shall be Violet Dudley.
What?
Get into her dress. Look for me in the pub in disguise.
The pub in disguise?
No, down at the docks in Soho.
Oh, no. Oh, Stones, what's my next step to be?
A hornpipe.
Oh, the horny pipe.
This big grizzly bear, you see.
Anybody here want a contact VD?
Look at the prow on that steamer.
That's the kind of big vermin I was telling you about, Tom.
Oh, well, let's climb aboard her.
I'm first.
I'm second, Matt.
Come here, tits.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah. Come sit on the face of a refined man.
Oh.
I'm hooked on you, missy.
Get that cold hook out of there.
Oh, that's cute. Drop your anchor and half a pint of ale with Stinkin' Orloff.
Well, thank you, Captain Stinkin'. I would rather fancy an ale.
Stand back, honey. One fancy ale coming up.
He forgot the glass. I can teach you a new disease I picked up in the Navy.
Well, perhaps another time, but I'm here to meet a friend.
Well.
Oh, there he is now.
Him? That ugly, burnout, peg-leg, pork-skinned fiddler?
You find him attractive?
Well, I...
Oh, I see what you mean.
Excuse me.
Outrageously disgusting disguise, Stones.
Nothing's too disgusting for old Dick Wrench.
What? Yes, I see, of course. Well, Jack, that was a sweet tune you were playing.
What?
I've been here for 5 minutes and no one slipped it to me yet.
Oh, yeah.
Have you got anything for me, Dick?
Like what?
Oh, anything you can't unwrap in here?
Oh, you mean this?
Oh, it is the clever.
I bet you've got a big box to put it in, har, har, har.
Not here outside, Stones.
Oh, it's shy, are you? Well, leave me get me dog and let's go. Come on, Blind Jim.
All right, then. We're quite alone now, Stones. Have you got it?
You'll find out. Get in that barrel, darling, and we'll do it hurricane style.
Wait a minute, what are you trying to
Enough
do?
Enough, sweet talk. Bend over. Here comes old one eye. What the? What the?
Oh, no! Oh, poor Stones. He's fallen in the water. Drowned. And he never told me if he had the parcel.
The wharf? Wharf?
Well, of course we're on the wharf. Roof. It's on the roof, of course. Stones, what an elaborate disguise, you dear fellow. A rat hound. Oh, you had me completely bamboozled. How did it feel in there? Rough? Well, I should imagine so. But think of me in these stays and whale bones. Oh, here, let me help you out now. Is this the zipper? Oh, well, I suppose not.
Cromwell! Cromwell, you flathead!
What? Where are you, Stones?
I'm over here in this tree suit.
Oh, thank God you're alive! Oh, down,
Stop
Jim,
playing
down.
With that infernal hound and lend me a hand!
Oh, bank on me, old man. I'll just open a front. What a relief!
That beastly dog soaked my trunks.
Oh, Stones, I'm so terribly sorry. I couldn't pick up the parcel.
Nonsense, my dear doctor. You were just talking to it.
Oh, what?
Here, Poochie. Here, here's a good fellow.
Come here. Look. Why, there's a little doggy door there under his tail.
No, no, careful, careful. I'll just lift this up.
Oh, there's the parcel, Stones.
Just as I suspected.
Oh, listen. Listen, it ticks.
No, the dog has ticks.
Then we must flee.
Woof, woof. Fleeing won't help you. I've got you covered.
Oh, God.
How ingenious.
Woof. I am Nobody's sweetheart!
Don't never fiend!
Ever get your hands on the secret invention?
Aha!
Means are doomed! What? Oh, is this exploding time?
Good heavens! Quick, Jetson! Give me the parcel and run this way!
I'll not escape its warning!
Can't run that way! I'm in a dress!
Something is happening! I don't know what it is! Oh, you!
All right, just a
stone! I'm back!
Swim for your life!
I'm back! I haven't exploded!
The mouth of that gift horse.
Senator Dudley, have you met Boyle M. Owl, president of the Bowel Oil Company?
How do you do?
How do you do what?
That's a great joke. Say, didn't we spend a weekend at Ted Clamstruck's Nig Island Retreat?
That's right. It's with Prick and Pat Ort.
Remember the brush was there, the writer's wife?
The pipe.
That was the weekend we played Hide the Housekeeper.
Right, an old body lost.
Yes, she's still lost. Well, gentlemen, ladies, fellow rich people. I see that both of Mickey's hands are pointing to 12. That means... Oh, shut up, Dud. I see that it's now 6 a.m. in Goonrat, where the gumboat Matilda Briggs, under my secret orders, is now docking with a hold full of Dudley Pignuts from the Senator's own Dudley Rubber Company, which I own.
You know, those natives have to have a constant supply of pignuts or they go out of their
heads. Yes, yes. Well, you see, this move diverts the world's supply of genuine pignut oil to the Chicago breweries of our good friend here, Boyle M. Owl, who I own.
I'm proud to be an owned man.
Yes, 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 yes. And with that much oil beer in the American working man, he'll be more than glad to turn out the lamps of the world.
You carry the big whip.
Wick. That's a wick. The Acme Whip Wick.
Why, that little gadget will blacken peasants' houses throughout the globe.
And where there's smoke, there's work. Yes, 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 gentlemen. But the pignut swindle is peanuts compared to the shocking surprise that should be... What? Wait a minute. What is it, Captain Darkashane?
Yes, Mr. Acme, sir. A thicker spare-bum two-hauler is signaling to land on deck, sir.
Oh, well, permission granted, and give us a good head of steam.
Aye, aye, sir.
Ah, the surprise is here now in the hands of my ward and heir, young Frank Acme, Jr.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Frank.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, Vine.
Hi, Frankie.
Is that a new dress?
Well, no, I'm still at the same old place.
Oh, I'll see you. Here's the secret package, Dad. See you later, bye.
Sure.
With the Zeppo tube in it.
Yes, you heard correctly, my friends. The Zeppelin tube, the search for which has boggled the great minds of science and made them soft. Look. The amplifier of unlimited power.
A power so great that it can only be used for good or evil.
And that choice has been left up to me.
And, sir, here's hoping you won't forget your promise.
What promise?
By the way, Dan, how does it exactly work?
Well, it's very electric and dangerous. Frank, Olaf?
Aye, sir.
Yes, would you rush this tube, please, to Dr. Archetype in the engine room? He'll know exactly what to do with it.
Aye, aye, sir. I'll be more than happy to take it off your hands. But first, Mr. Acme, I'd like to get to the bottom of this little charade, if you don't mind.
Who is this man?
Oh, Dad, this is Hemlock Stones, the master of deductions.
Deductions, did you say? Well, maybe you could tell me how to take these business dinners off.
Elementary, Acme. 10 laps around the deck.
Oh, never thought.
Well, this is fascinating, Mr. Stones, but I'd better get that tube down below.
Yes, I'm sure you'd like to, young man. L-A-Z.
L-A-Z come, L-A-Z go. Be right back, Dad.
Canadian. Now, Flotsam, give Miss Dudley the parcel.
Oh, you got it. What's in it, Dr. Flotsam?
Oh, nothing but a tin of red herrings in heavy oil.
Yes, something of no importance whatever.
No, you were to be a decoy, my dear.
Then I was in danger.
We were sitting ducks, me in the dock in the dark on the docks with a dog, the deadly dog.
I say, the tale of the deadly dog. What a splendid title for this story.
You're quite a wag, old wig, but I fear this story has not yet been written.
Don't
oh, really?
Dad,
what a rush. Can you feel that acceleration?
Woo! That's faster than anyone's ever been gone before.
That's right, Vi. We'll hit New York late tomorrow morning.
And dock in Chicago in time for lunch. Dredging in the process, thank you. The Acme Canal. Flow bridge on the Acme
Canal. Good heavens! Get your hands off me, Flutter! Mr. Acme,
what is it, Captain? What's happening?
You're losing power! I'm trying to switch over, but I... Ha!
And your loss is my game. Now that I have the Zeppo tube, the world is my oyster, except for the month with an R in them.
That voice.
Oh, laugh at the electrician. I'm not funny. I'm serious.
Oh, listen, listen. He's stealing Frank's bad, Dad.
That's Frank's bad.
Look, Stones! Look, he's stolen the Zeppelin tubes!
All is lost!
Not quite, Mr. Acme. Hemlock Stones is still on the case. I shall pursue this arch-villain to the very edge of the center of the earth, even if it costs you £100.
You'll risk your life for £100?
I'll risk anybody's life for £100 of dollars, my dear Acme.
Well, then it's a deal.
Flip me my fiddle, Flotsam!
thank you. Thank you, and here we go. What a day for this history-making remote broadcast. This is Joe Beats over WX21 Chicago. I hope you're hearing this now as I'm speaking from the lawn of Bridhurst Manor, the high society home of Jonas Acme, fair-haired pharaoh of American industry. A grim, closed-mouthed Chief O'Moriarty pushed his way through the pack of yapping newshounds and a growing crowd of curiosity seekers barely 10 minutes ago while we were setting up our equipment. Now, while we're waiting for a statement from inside the great house, let me bring you, those of you who can hear me right now, up to date. First, the mysterious theft in mid-Atlantic of a secretly developed power generator, the heart of the Acme All Night Light and Power Company. Then, announcement of indefinite delay in the construction of the Acme Canal. What a blow to the Windy City. And all this in the midst of the worst electrical crisis of our new modern decade, as trolleys, iron hearts, and cattle prods switch on and off like a crazy monkey. The reason? Possibly that glowing gas bag that plunged zizzing into Lake Acme early last week. But no, that story's gonna have to wait, for here comes that daredevil dandy himself, Frank Acme Jr. in his high-toned yellow runabout. Just work my way down to the... Getting out of the car with young Frank is the celebrated English crime stopper, Hemlock Stone.
Frank, I can't... Can you tell us what's going on inside?
I can, but I can't.
Can the Acme stock stand the slaughtering? It's getting in the market.
We'll bull through it.
Tell me, Mr. Stones. Mr. Stones, have you got a statement for the radio listeners?
Yes, I'm quite jazzed to be here in Chicago, the home of the vacuum flapper, pig oil beer, and the Zeppelin chew.
This is the microphone, sir. This is the microphone here.
I see, instrument. And here's a special hello to its new owner, I'm sure he's listening, that twisted genius who should be beneath all this, the electrician.
The electrician, Mr. Stone? Who's he, and how's he connected with this case?
Yes, excuse me, Mr. Stones, but we mustn't keep Dad and his police waiting.
Quite fright, Frank. But I would like to say...
Boys, Dad ought to give you all enough to chew on, boys.
What's he going to do now? What do you think of American girls?
Well, they're both going inside now, and what a shocker this is. That dynamo of detective energy has switched some new light on current events, sparking the positive hope that he's going to run the negative force to ground. Wow. And now, while we're waiting for something to happen here, we return to the Cubist Lounge, the sophisticated music of the Hotel Vermouth, for Big Louis and his continental cocktail. Are we off, Joe?
Sergeant, close the door, please.
Yes, Mr. Acme, Junior, sir. Sir, go right in there, waiting for you in the flute room.
Okay. Sorry about our local news dog, sir, nipping at your heel, but...
That's all right.
Don't you think you have bitten off more than you can chew?
Well, lad, what's cheese for the mouse is a snack for the rat.
Gee, what is all this animal imagery,
I'd rather bit them than bite them, Doctor.
Does it have any meaning?
I don't care, Dougley. Look, we'll just have to hold on. I can't hear you. This phone keeps cutting on and off like a crazy monkey.
Hello, everyone.
Look, just tell the president to put it between two pieces of bread and eat it.
It's all right.
Goodbye.
About the little rat.
I mean, Sal. Stones, where have you been? Turn off that radio.
Hi, Dad.
Chief, hi, son. The chief and I have been waiting here for over an hour.
Oh, Mr. Stones, really? Just wanted to see where the gas bag hit the lake, Dad.
Yes, it left a great gaping hole in the water.
Well, damn it and fry it. What do holes in Lake Acme have to do with the theft of my tube?
Well, there's an old Swiss saying, Mr. Acme. Trouvez le raton, trouvez le trou.
That's Canadian, sir, to find the rat.
Look for the hole, right, Chief?
Bulls, pizzles, you frogs don't know a hop in hell about American crime. Leave it to me and the boys in black and blue, sir. We're ready to terrorize every small shopkeeper and roust every decent citizen out of his private home.
I don't think, Chief Moriarty, that you'll find this fiend at home.
Shut up!
Take it easy, Chief.
I don't care how you do it or who does it. I want that electrician behind bars.
Well, I'm behind the bar right now. Cocktails, anyone?
I'll say.
Irish coffee for me.
Okay, just open a quick Jeroboam of champagne for everyone, Vi.
Okay, Frankie.
Coke for me, please. I understand it comes in bottles in this country.
Oh, here you are, Mr. Stone.
Oh, thank you.
Private industrial stock.
Just a moment. This drink may be doped.
Oh,
yes, it is. How refreshing. Did you know they once found a rat tail in one of these bottles?
Oh, disgusting.
Rat parts. Ha ha, you see, Plotsom. I played the part of the rat.
Yes, indeed, Stones, I do see.
But the twitchy-nosed goon rat officialdom triumphed.
Get your rats off in a triumph?
The rodent control board pressured us.
Rode on the running board?
And I was written out.
Driven out, oh, Stones, those vermin.
Precisely, and gentlemen,
The biggest of them all eats the most electricity.
So what,
Stones? So I must follow the rat to find the cat before the rat eats the cat that's under the house that Jack built. Acme.
What?
How much, Jack, did this house host?
Horse corsets? You're insane,
you can't
Stones.
Squeeze any sense out of that limey's juice.
That's right, Chief. The more juice, the better.
Not in my country club.
This electrician is in more danger than he could possibly know. You see, each time the tube is used, he is drawn closer, ever closer, into the juicy jaws of fate.
Excuse me, everybody. I think I have to go to the bathroom.
Well, all this blarney's not putting anybody in jail. I'm going, because we're going to get your electric thingamajig back if we have to drag every wobbly red to his feet and knock him back down the church steps.
Do your worst, Chief. Your future unemployment depends on it.
Shut up.
All right, Stones. If you're through playing a cat and rat with us, how do you intend to get a jump on the electrician?
Well, actually, I think I'll go jump in the lake.
Oh, no. Oh, keep rolling, Stones. You can find it just a shot away.
But, Doctor, my dear fellow, I've found him already.
He'll never find me.
There, you see, it worked. I flushed him out.
I am the electrician.
I know that
speaking
voice.
Through the radio. It's amazing. You can do it, too. All you need, Epilin tube.
That's my tube.
Infinite power and be yours.
Now, just a second. I want my tube back.
Personal message. Where did Jonas go when the lights went out?
This is my house, and I don't...
Look out, look out! I've got them now!
You certainly do, and you can take your hands right off them!
Oh, all right, everyone, calm down. I've got the lights. Turn off that damn radio.
The lights went out in the bathroom, and I missed everything. What a mess.
No, what's amiss? And what's amiss is your father.
Oh, Jonas is missing!
Gosh, you mean my dad's been hijacked by criminals?
Yes, well, he's kidnapped. But we'll find him. Tell me, Frank, how does one get to be a criminal in this town?
I drink beer.
Smoke rag.
Maybe dance on
Sundays.
And where does one do that?
At a low dive with continuous entertainment.
Like the Mobius Dick. They wail all night.
No, Vi. That's a very cheesy place.
Sure
Dad would never be found in a hole in the wall like that.
Wait, tell me
there on my Au contraire, Frank. A hole in the wall is just the spot to trap a rat.
No.
Let's go.
I don't think so, Mr.
I'll get
Stone.
A new dress.
I think we ought to start at the public
sponge. Where's everybody going? Wait for me.
Keep quiet, and I'll handle everything.
I get to handle it now.
Shh, please. I don't think we should...
Okay, I'm coming.
Mr. Stones, let's
Mobius
just...
Dick Funeral Parlor. You snuff him, we stuff him.
That's very clever. I'm Joe from Chicago, my good man. Let us in.
You're Joe from... How do I know you're Joe from Chicago?
I live here.
Well, who are these other lugs, then?
My mob, Southside,
hi.
Veronica Lakeshore,
and
Louis the Loop.
The dishonor is all mine,
wait,
sir.
Wait a minute, Fops. Why are you speaking with a French accent?
Well,
we're in disguise.
I get it. Well, what's the secret password?
Oh, no, you don't, sir. I shall never be tricked into telling it. It's a secret.
You got it. Good for you. I'd forgotten it, too. Come on in.
What a smoke and a real nice guy, Joe from Chicago and his mob.
Glad to have you back, Joe.
Disarmed, I'm sure.
Joe, this here is Harold the Hawk Lunget and his gang, Willard.
Shall I wipe him off, boss? Shall I drive him around the block? Let me clean his car, boss.
Curb your rat, Hawk.
Hey, don't mind Willard, see? He's just a syncopathic killer. Drop your dog, see? Slide in, see? Have an oil beer, see?
You too, please.
Mr. Stones, this is a dangerous smoke.
Easy, Mr. Stones. Our disguises won't hold up long here.
What do you mean?
It's a job for the team, and I'm going to...
Hey, where are you going, shortstop?
I'm going to go case the bathroom.
Join the table, Joe.
Oh, thank you.
So I thought I'd never meet Joe from Chicago, see? You know, we got a friend in common.
Oh, really?
Jim Fang, see?
Oh, Jim C. Fang.
Yes,
I knew him. I may have bumped into him once.
That's rich. Bumped him off, you mean? Hey, honey, you're a swell flapper. What's under the flap?
Watch it there, bug eyes. Keep your peepers off my mole.
Mole?
Who's the professor?
I'm a practicing physician, sir.
Well, when you stop practicing, see? I got a couple of slugs in my back garden, see? I want removed, see?
Clip him, boss. I'll shrink his hedge. I'll mow him down.
Go squeeze a tomato, Willard. They're playing your song.
Let me squeeze this one.
Just a second, old man.
Just a second, old man.
It's ladies' choice, Ratso.
Thanks, Joe.
Come on, Louis, let's rag.
Oh, delighted, Ronnie. I do a colorful Afghani bondage dance. The beggars crawl, Sumatran kick, dance.
They make a nice couple, don't they? She sets him up, he knocks her down.
Plant those bozos, Willard, see?
I'll throw him the fish out.
Well, Joe, what do you know?
What?
What's your swindle, see? Oh. A snatch, a heist, bunco, the rackets?
Oh, no, no, no. Pig nuts. Bogus pig nuts.
Oh, big time.
You betcha.
Me, I'm up to my nose in candy.
Really?
Here's a little 2-pound sampler you can take home to the little woman. Make her littler. Try one.
Ah, nose candy.
Yeah.
Mmm, smells good, too.
Ah, don't horn the ones with the cherries in the middle, Joe. You'll suffocate.
I like the powdered sugar at the bottom of the box best.
Ah, more. More sugar, I get it. That's rich. See? Ha, ha, ha.
Ah. Oh, good stuff. There's a ring in my ears.
I'll get it. It's Herr Lungitz's table. You're talking to the hawk, see? What's so funny about that? Ha, 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 yourself.
You want me to cut him off, Boris?
Relax, Willard. Boris, it's for you. Some weird electrician on the wire. Repairs or something, see?
The boss, I know who that is. Thanks, Hal.
Nord wires, no doubt.
Nord who?
Just an ingenue I know.
Joe, you're wired.
You want me to pull this plug?
No, take it easy.
Hi, boss. Where do you want Mr.? Oh. He wants me to use the criminal's code. Hello, sweetheart. I picked up the bag of pickles and took them to your mother's house. I knocked him out. Asleep in the linen closet. What's so funny? Put the pickles in. Put the pickles in where? You mean, no. You mean the linen closet, don't you? Look, turn the organ down a little. I can hardly hear you. Okay, dear. Have it your way. I'll put the pickles in the galoshes, but I still think... No, I like your organ, honey, and I love you. Don't cry. Oh, you're laughing. Okay, sweetheart. Glad you see it that way. I'm signing off now. O-F. Goodbye. I mean, hello.
Huh? Excuse me, gents, but I've got
to
go.
To the bathroom.
No, yes.
Yes.
I mean the linen closet.
Yes, well, I have to see a dog about a man, too.
Yeah, Joe, I know what you mean. This oil beer goes through you like a hot car, see? Yeah, speaking of which, what kind of touring car you like to steal when you're doing where's everybody gone?
It's a case of the air get poisoning. Just imagine a whole town high on rye.
Oh, that must have been before pro-inhibition.
Glad you're back, sister. Hey, Professor, your friend just took a powder, see?
Oh, really? What did he say? Did you take notes?
I only take what don't belong to me, see?
You boys, excuse me. I have to powder my knees.
Well, let me escort you to the facilities.
Hey, the party's pooping out on me. What's happening? Hey, Blutwurst, come on over here, see? I need somebody to
talk to. Oh, doctor, you don't need to go with me, really.
Oh, but I do, my dear. This foreign dancing gives me the fearful shuffles.
Oh, I caught them in Buffalo once. Well, here's the little Sheba's room. Bye-bye.
Sheba's, over here. Sheiks. Well, this must be the gents.
Wait, Mr. Stones, we have to get out of here or we'll get caught in the rain.
It's occupied. My dear, I'm beginning to shuffle, too.
I saw him come in here, and what goes in must come out. Fudge law, lad. Fudge law. By God, I've got it.
What?
A rat hole. Pickles down the rat hole. It's on Harry.
Stones, I say. Is that you?
But I don't have to.
From the inside.
Stones, come on, then, Professor Stones. Now, who's in there?
Stones! I say, Frankenstein, God, it's monstrous.
Come on this way, Mr. Acme. Come on. I can't come that way. My knees are tied together.
Now your gag's falling out again. I don't know about that Willard. He doesn't know any good knots. Then I don't know any good gags.
Where the hell are we? In hell?
Hell? No, Mr. Atkins, we're right under your house, near your nightclub.
Then these are my sewers.
That's enough now, Turkey. You're on the short end of the fuse of doom.
The electrician's gonna pull your plug.
Come on now. Come this way. Come on, Frank.
Stones. I'm sure we took the wrong pipe back here.
That's my pipe. Keep up, Frank. I can see the beady, greedy eyes of that heinous, hideous rat. There, you see. Ha ha! Winking at me, glowing in the dark at the end of the tunnel.
Sir, let's...
Come on, I'm out of here now.
I'm coming.
Golly, all this lost. My ass is wet.
Follow me, boss. Follow me, my nose.
Yeah, I see. It's glowing, see?
I smell a rat.
Yeah, Joe from Chicago, see? Taking over my sewer, see?
I see. Oh, I'll find him, boss. I'll come through the walls. I'll squeak in the night.
He'll go down the floor.
Yeah, see?
I am Boris, your humble slave unit, ninth degree, fuse bearer to your alternating eminence. I bring the vile and trembling victim along the circuit of doom. Between the rows of crossed switches, up the twisting coil of least resistance.
Come on.
Transforming him step by step, conducting him finally across the great voltage drop. Don't fall. And finally, placing him on the holy grid of electric blue. Now, master, tool of the universe, expose yourself to us.
Oh, maybe I didn't get that part right. Oh, now, master, instrument of the universe.
I am the technician. I did it in vain. I'll be with you in a minute.
Boy, what a guy. See, Mr. Acme, what a magnetic personality. Oh, wait till you see his costume. It's not rented. Oh, you got to have some lines in the ceremony, veteran. Gag it. Tell you, if he don't kill you, you'll love working for him.
I don't work for anybody. Everybody works for me.
Honey, that's what I was going to say.
You mad fiend.
As I am revealed to you, Acme, and we meet face to mask.
Where's my tube?
Our tube. Here it is. Oh. And sacrificing my life and smelling curtains for you.
You crazy monkey. All you criminals can do is stop elevators and break iron hearts.
I have earned its awesome secrets. Soon. I will know what to do with it.
I have that vision already. I know what to do with it. Think. Slicer dicers that grow in the dark. Rubber roads that lead nowhere. Gas bags, zizzing tanned, happy people to work anywhere in the world. Digital beds, watches that won't melt. Movies in hotels, ant-proof casters, lights that never go out. A cure for the shuffles. Cheap art and compulsive education and all of this part. 61! The future! Easy! Efficient! Affordable! What's happening to my voice?
Antipathetic! I knew you'd say that! What about the smoke? What about the corksman? What about reality? You cry for progress, I scream for ice cream!
That's not funny.
What about the little people?
You mean the... Comes?
What about the rats?
Sneaking a rat, see? Look what we caught squeaking outside the door, see?
I was just about to let myself in.
Sure.
Get your paws off me.
Uh-oh. Ask out the infidel.
T-Man ran to the joint upstairs, see?
I must not be seen by the clean.
Hey, who's the mug in the mask?
I'm going to clean up in the bathroom.
Oh, look, you're scared the boss away, the hawk.
I'm sorry,
why'd you bring Willard and Joe from Chicago in here? What happened to Joe's nose?
This rodent Gunsel bit it off.
It's a nice nose. It's rubber. I like it. It's rubber. It's chewing.
It'll ruin your teeth.
It'll last.
Stones, have they got you too?
Indeed. It would appear that we are all initiates to the Temple of the Electrician, High Priest of False Security.
You could be fined for saying that in the temple.
Just try it.
Hold it, you criminals!
Oh, it's Frank Acme Jr., see? Call my lawyer!
America stands ready to knock down every bully, thug, or hired goon on the block!
Bravo, Frank!
My boy!
Hide his filaments, boss.
He's a Chenebrath. You can't bite American's action hero, see?
That's right, Lunger!
Lung
you
it.
Criminals have run up a big bill of rights, and now you're gonna pay for it in just a minute!
Where are you going, Frank?
Willard, we're 23 in before that fighting devil dog comes back, see?
Boss!
Don't worry, Lunger. I've got Lung that it. Junior D-man trapped in my
bedroom. Stones, make this monster give me back my tube!
But it's not your tube.
What?
You see, it's my tube.
No, it's not your tube either.
Whose
it's
tube
his
is it?
Tube.
What, little Willard?
Willard?
Yes,
Willard?
Look, everyone, at okay. What's happening to his eyes. And the way his teeth are glowing. Willard, you're a Sumatran, aren't you? A guardian of the Temple of Ampere Watt.
What?
Where was secreted the sacred Orb Watam?
What am I?
Oh, roughly translated, the useless tool or tube from heaven. But perhaps they were wrong, eh, Acme?
What do you mean?
Those simple natives, none of them bigger than a ruddy English schoolboy. It could be of some use to an industrial visionary IQ. So, during the heat of the summer ret dance, you, Acme, stole it.
I didn't steal it. I stole it to save it from senseless worship.
Yes.
All that boogity-boo.
Yes, it was you hiding in the rat's eye.
That's right, Dad. You are a criminal.
What? Uh-oh. He blew his fuse. I'm getting out of here. See?
The boss blew his fuse.
Search is over. It's ours again. I've got it. I'm coming home. Oh, Brother Rat.
Stop that little squealer.
Gosh.
Oh, it's fine. Terribly sorry. I seem to have tripped over a cord and pulled out a plug or something.
Flotsam, my dear friend. Stones. You've lost the cord, but saved the day.
Oh, gee, well. Mr. Stones, I guess I'm too late.
Oh, Frank, I'm so glad to see you. We were all hopelessly lost, like Adam and Eve.
Help me untie Dad, Bye.
Untie Stones. He has to catch the electrician and get the tube.
No. There's the electrician.
Me?
What?
No. Son? He's right behind you. That rented costume there on the floor.
Frank,
lad, you should have it as a memento of this entertaining crime.
Oh, well, gee, thanks.
Well, sentiments, everyone, but what about the tube?
It's with Willard. It's safe in the paws of its ancient guardians. And speaking of paws, here's the one that refreshes.
Stones, you snowball, where is the sacred tube?
It's quite safe, on its way, on a slow boat to Java. Getting back to where it once belonged. But not, dear friends, where it began. Which brings us to the beginning.
But Stones, this is the end.
Exactly, spaceman. Write this down.
I am.
And so, the myth of the electrician...
And so, Mr. Patrician...
...was exploded at last.
Exploded, I guess.
Like his hideous clockwork rat-hound Tojo.
Like some hidden crook found back in Soho.
My labor's now completed.
The lady's now depleted.
My dear compendium and I...
My fear the end is nigh.
...discreetly to our suites at the Holiday Inn.
Turn these sheets in for some meat of a horrible day's end.
Thankful that for tonight, Hackley...
always right, like me.
Chicagoans might sleep like crazy monkeys.
Night deep for lazy money.
Under an electrical blanket.
Underhanded electoral...
American, combustible, violent.
Distrustful, silent, sir.
No, Flotsam.
What?
Violins, old chap. Violins!
Oh!